people's mind, I'm going to go buy this lawnmower, I'm going to cut all this grass, I'm going to get all these contracts, I'm going to be AA certified, I'm going to be this. I'm telling you what people believe. What was that moment for you?
When my company made that $1.4 million.
Girl, say that again.
Well, my company.
And when was that one? After how many years? And be transparent.
What, 8 or 9
years? Yeah, they think, and then tomorrow they're going to make $1 million.
And the thing about it is, you know, wealth comes from, I have to pay a staff. So people that don't understand, I have an actual business. I pay employees.
Really, Tonya?
Ain't nothing to it. Real one. Ain't nothing to it. Boss. Ain't nothing to it.
Nothing to it.
Real one. Ain't nothing to it.
Nothing.
Boss. A bit of cost. Ooh, gon' take it all.
Take it all.
I record, then I ball.
Then I ball.
I ignored a lot of calls. You ain't talking about nothing, I ain't got no time. Got that dinero on my mind. Ooh, I got real problems just like you. Tell that bitch I don't like you.
I don't fuck with you.
Ain't nothing to it. Real one. Ain't nothing to it.
Spiritually grounded, and God is the CEO of my my life, and I always feel like every single day without him, I would not be where I am.
Absolutely.
And so I appreciate you having me on this podcast. Y'all not about to get my business, because again, this is the Overly Tonya Show. So I'm not about to get y'all in my business, but we can talk about some business things. And I am the owner of a HR consulting company. I've now been open 17 years.
Girl, that's a whole shout. That's a whole phrase. That's a whole band. That seriously, sis, that is just, you deserve all your flowers. And I hope you're getting them. I hope you're continuing to receive them. I know every time I get the chance, I like treat my friend. I just am so proud of my friend. I love everything about that. That's amazing.
And I'm going to say this too, because Tonya is one of the friends that, like, really one of the best friends, my sister, that I have. She does not equate me having money that I should do everything. No. She's that friend. She doesn't care about, it doesn't matter that I'm successful in my own right. Yeah. She's still going to look out. She's still going to treat. She's still going to show. And we have shown up in each other's lives for so many things. And not just these happy times, y'all see.
Yes, honey.
We have shown up through the broken moments, yeah, a lot of bad times. We've survived a lot. And it's crazy because we went through a lot at the same time.
Yeah. It's amazing how God's environment has been to us. Talk to us about your journey. Like, why do you get into entrepreneurship? Because you are absolutely excellent when it comes to entrepreneurship. You have really set the bar. You set the standard. And, you know, I'm going to be talking a lot about business on this show because we got to do better. Customer service is at an all-time low. And we got to get to that. You know, customer service is going to be a big thing I'm going to be talking about a lot on this show. And I'm going to be talking about these men needing some healing. But we're going to say that for another show. But there are two things that's heavy on my heart. Customer service when it comes to business and when it comes to relationships, the broken men, they need some healing. And why won't they go get what they need? But we're going to talk about that later.
That's a whole pajama party.
That's a whole nother topic. Yeah, we're going to have a pajama party. We're going to have some fun. So I'm just trying to prep you guys for what you can look forward to with Really Tonya. Really Tonya?
And I work for corporate America most of my life. I started off in the D.C. Superior Courthouse in D.C. and just rewind.
So you're from D.C.?
I'm from the DMV area, but, you know, I guess we'll say PG County.
PG.
Because that's where I grew up. Yeah. And they just changed it over to the DMV area. And that's where I grew up. And that's where my parents' homes were and so forth. And so I worked for some really major companies. D.C. Superior Courthouse, Fannie Mae, to name a few. I work for the state of North Carolina.
Oh, wow.
So I work for federal government.
Yeah.
I work for the Mint, which was the part of the Department of Treasury. So I work for a lot of companies. My career is in HR.
Yeah.
And I said, it has to be more than life than sitting behind this desk shuffling these papers.
Yeah.
And so 2007, January 31st, the exact
date. The exact day, January 31st. I love that. I love that.
I didn't even put in a full resignation. I put that resignation in. It was like 6 days later, I left.
And he was out of there.
And I started my staffing company with two clients. Started my staffing company with two clients.
Now, let me ask you something. Wow. Where you get your clients from?
Well,
we
can talk about it now. Really Tonya.
Well, how did you get your clients?
Well, I always
first started.
Well, I oversaw a lot of our staffing. Well, I oversaw all of it. And I approved all the staffing for managers and meet staffing. So my clients came from working at the station.
You took their price.
I was a little bit fraternizing.
You took their price.
I didn't say they were
that. It's nothing wrong with that, sis.
Well, in hindsight, in the state world, it was something wrong with it. You should not work and then go start a business and use the clients that you got from the job.
Really?
So I don't. Yes, that's probably an old really Theresa moment at that moment. But
yeah.
I had two clients and I got my first contract and needed 40 call center folks.
Yes, sir.
And I had no staff, it was just me, but I made it happen. So fast forward, 17 years later, we have transitioned so much.
Yeah.
TMI Group has transitioned so much. So now we are an HR consulting company and background screen vendor, payroll, processing center, and we do all IT contracts.
And I'm a client. I am a client.
And she's a client.
So when they say that women can't work together, you can't support your friends, businesses, they don't. No, I'm a client. And I will say, she's my friend. You know, when I first got started, she made sure that I was good. She made sure that I started slow and she brought me in. But, you know, at the end of the day, why would I not do business to support your business? That makes no sense. But I think sometimes why people have a hard time with that. But I think because me and you respect business so much and we respect our relationship so much, it's got in the way.
Absolutely. I totally agree with that. And I think a lot of times now we live in a world where we got these women empowered.
empowerment groups and all these all things women. Yeah. However, but nobody, a lot of times women are not going to give you all their ingredients to help.
They're not going to be the blueprint.
So outside of the HR,
what else do you do?
I got into trucking.
How'd you get into trucking?
By default, my husband had been driving trucks for like almost 30 years.
Yeah, for sure.
And so I got into trucking, we got trucks, we got contracts, and we built a business together on the trucking side. And, you know, now that we're not doing business together as partnerships anymore, I stayed in the business.
Yeah.
So when we stand in the business, getting my own trucks and getting contracts, and I recently, 2 years ago, opened up a CDL school. But my babies, trucking, the school, HR consulting, I'm just going to be candid with you guys. Those are my companies and fully staffed, so I don't have to be there. That's why I'm here talking to you guys. But my baby is really...
Yes, honey.
Stella Taste Wines.
Let me tell y'all something. Let me be very real with you. I'm not a wine drinker. You know, give me the hard stuff, give me some champagne. But when she did this, this was it. And the fact that I'm gonna get you to share the journey of how this came about, because this is big stuff. You know, trucking is good, HR is good, you know, being able to be coached by Theresa, being trained, you've helped a lot of people get into business and be successful, including myself. All of those things are great. But honey, to build something that typically is not owned by us, people that look like us, females, because I say it all the time, I truly feel like sometimes we can be the most disrespected. And so for you to be able to stand and be able to create something from the ground up is amazing. And I'm not just saying this because you're my friend. I'm telling you the truth. This is my favorite. This is my wine. So this was at my house. I bought it here personally. I've been holding on to this bottle. So I really support my friends. Like, this is real talk. So, where did the name come from? Where did you come from with Stella, and how did it get started? Where did this come from?
I'm a wine lover. I love wine. And I used to drink alcohol. But you know what? I got tired of getting up the next day and people telling me things I did that I didn't remember.
Ooh, child.
And I'm just going to be candid.
The other day?
Right?
Oh, okay.
I'm just going to be candid. I would drink alcohol, and I would get up the next day, because alcohol changes your character. And I would get up the next day, and like, yeah, you curse so-and-so out. You said so. I'm like, huh? Not me. So,
we get all of that. You guys put it in the chat.
It went all in years, but all you guys can relate, because with alcohol, you're going to get emotional. Right? You're going to start bringing out things you didn't have the courage to talk about when you were sober. So it was like, okay, these stories have been going on too long for too long. So I actually converted over to drinking wine, and not your richest wine and all that type of stuff. No disrespect.
For sure.
Because I don't even like Taylor Port. I think that's cooler wine.
Yeah. We tried to do.
Oh,
yeah,
it's terrible.
Yeah, it's cooler wine. But the thing is, I am a connoisseur of wine. I love wine. I like the way wine tastes. I like to learn what wine goes with. So, during COVID, I flew to Napa Valley to start the process. And that's where the process started. When I went to Napa Valley, you got to be involved with all pieces of the taste, the flavor. This site has the raspberry, cherry, teaching you what it pairs good with.
Yeah.
And so I'm on this wine journey. And even right now, I'm trying to partner with a restaurant in Italy. Well, they'll be actually housing the Stella Taste Wine.
Girl, tell them again.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm partnering with a company in Italy.
My friend. I have the best sisters.
But Stella comes to me from Superb. And I think that's what I thought about my wine.
I never knew that.
Yes. And the vision came to me at 3 o'clock in the morning. Because y'all know how it is. Y'all get up and go pee, right? At 3 o'clock.
Yeah,
and you lay back down and all these thoughts run through your mind. Yeah. But when I thought Stella, that's what I felt about this wine. And it's crazy because Tony doesn't even drink wine.
I don't drink wine.
But she drinks this. My sister doesn't drink wine, but my sister loves Stella
Taste
Wine.
But I drink that wine, and it's the taste. I drank a whole bottle one night. I was at your house, and I was like, oh my God, how in the world did I drink a whole, I'll pay for it the next morning. But again, like you said, it's a different type of feeling the next day versus liquor.
Yes.
I'm going to agree with her on that. But it takes too long for me. I'm sorry. The only thing about wine, it takes too long. Guys, I want that instant, baby. Give me hype. Give me joy.
You're not going to get that.
But I'm telling you, it's superb. I'm so proud of you. I don't even have enough words to describe to see you create something like this. And to go to California and handpick and do the work you went and did the work, created your own perfect creation, a stellar taste line. I couldn't be more proud of you. So what can we expect next? Where do you see this going? Contract.
Well, my company.
And when was that? After how many years? I need transparent.
Probably 8 or 9
Yeah. They think, yeah, they think tomorrow they're going to make $1 million.
And the thing about it is, you know, wealth comes from, I have to pay a staff. So people, you know, people that don't understand, I have an actual business. I pay employees.
Yeah.
And so the 1.4 million go in my pocket. And that's why I think people mix
you
it up.
You say that all the time.
Yeah, because people get it mixed up.
Seriously,
like, you know, my salary might run $150,000 to $170,000 a year, but the 1.4 million go in my pocket because I need my staff. And right now I have 54 employees.
Oh, yes, sir. And that's my friend.
Mm-hmm. And that's a lot to be responsible for. But that's when I realized. I'm a mama, I made it.
Yeah.
And then increase to that. But let me just tell you about mama making it. You get the 2.4 million, you get the 5 million, 6 million, all that. But let me tell you something, honey, IRS will kick your ass.
I was going to say this. You know, we're going to have the taxes piece.
They are.
When did you realize how important it was for you to start paying taxes? When was that time when you said, oh, shit, the IRS ran the corner?
I always paid taxes. Always did my taxes quarterly,
okay.
And I did them monthly. But when you start getting tax statements and you owe 900,000, 874,000, as much as you think that you made it,
yeah.
You owe 60,000. These are not regular taxes.
These are not regular taxes, baby.
And so that's when you know that you have built something
successful. Yeah.
And as much as you may be pissed, when you get to that tax bracket, you know that you have built something successful. And the crazy thing is, I'm much more frugal now with my money.
You are frugal.
I'm so frugal. They call me cheap, but I don't use the word cheap. I don't even like cheap. I'm frugal. Because what I learned is just because you have it, I mean you have to spend it.
Yeah, absolutely. I agree. I love this for
you.
And it looks so good. It looks so amazing on you.
Thank you.
It looks so good on you. When I see you, it's just an automatic glow. And I know it's much more that you've been through that's gotten here. We'll say that for another time. But what we do want to make sure we understand is how can they get this great old Stella Tasty Wine?
Hey, Stella! 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 Stella!
This is my wine choice.
So,
I need all my friends to
please make sure you follow us.
All my followers.
On social media, Stella Tasty Wines. It does have an S on it. And we're on Instagram, Facebook, and TikTok, Stella Tasty Wines.
Yeah.
And there's a link on all of the social media sites where you can just click and buy.
Yes,
okay, if you have any questions, please feel free to email us info@stellartastewines.com. All right, and we'll be able to go out there and see. We're actually building our e-commerce site.
Yeah.
That's about wrapped up. So on the e-commerce site, you can order 4 bottles or you can order 40 bottles.
Mm.
And so it'll be automatically shipped from Napa Valley. So,
yeah.
But I do keep wine on hand.
She does. I grabbed some last week when she was passing through on her way to D.C.
And so now I feel crazy. Like, I'm like, why am I going to buy this wine out the store? I own wine.
Yeah.
So, you know, it's a different thing. So
yeah.
I'm excited about it. But again, Stellar Taste Wines with an S if you are interested in purchasing a bottle or 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 bottles.
Absolutely. And before we wrap up, is there any nuggets that you want? Do you have anything left that you would want to share? Any quick nuggets that you want to share, because the folks that are listening, they're new, aspiring. Some of them are seasoned, experienced entrepreneurs. But what I'm finding out is it doesn't matter how much time you've been an entrepreneur, it's how effective you've been, how successful you've been. It's so easy to start a bunch of businesses, but if you're not making no money, if you're not paying taxes, do you really have a business? That's where we got to get to. I applaud everybody for trying and starting, getting started and restarting. You know, over and over again, because that's the key. The key is to keep going, to not give up. The key is if you fall, it's not working, just restart and start over. But we have when I look at the number of businesses that started every year, how many of those are really successful businesses, and are people really operating as a business? So if there is any nuggets you want to drop before you leave.
I will drop these. Be consistent.
Yeah.
Okay. Stay in your lane. And mind your business and drink your water.
Drink your water. I am working on all of that.
And those are things that I would say, because a lot of times we go look at social media and add this facade. It's like a big playground.
Yeah.
Don't try to keep up with the Joneses. It's try to do your thing and stay in your lane.
Yeah.
Be consistent again and drink your water and mind your business.
Because I know Joneses are really broke. But anyway, we're going to start for another time.
I know a lot of Joneses really are broke.
They really are broke. They're faking it till they make it.
Yeah.
And it's nothing wrong with that at all. We all are. We're in this motion. And there's nothing wrong with that. That's all I'm saying. biggest thing. And Teresa hits on consistency. Let me tell you something. If you can be consistent at something over a long period of time, you begin to build a strong habit and you begin to create something where you do it every single day. And that's how you begin to get success. Success starts with doing the little small things every day, all the time, and it's going to build up over time. So keep that in mind. Well, I want to thank Teresa for stopping by as usual. No surprise to me that she's here. One thing I know I can always count on you. So even if you're not physically here, you're always with me in spirit. So thank you so much for joining us. Absolutely. Please make sure you grab your Stella Taste wine. Grab it. If you didn't get all the information, make sure that you go to my page. I'm going to make sure it's posted as well. We'll make sure you have the links. I'm not available to bring you your bottle, so I'm telling you right now to just go online and get your bottle like I do.
And it goes well with doggy style.
It really does. So let me just say this because I ain't going to say what food is falling below. I'm going to say that right there. But anyway, thank you guys so much for joining me. Oh my God, I'm really doing this, y'all. Really doing it. I'm really doing this. So guys, thank you so much for tuning in and joining me. Don't forget, follow me on all platforms, Instagram and Facebook, Really Tonya. And then make sure that you tune into my YouTube channel. Make sure that you go to Spotify and Apple. I'm going to be everywhere. I'm coming for you guys. So if you enjoyed this episode and you want to see more episodes, keep following me. We have so much more to give you. But I had to start up here, guys. I had to give you the top of the iceberg. Thank you so much for joining. Really Tonya. Y'all have a good night. Peace.